2 years ago, the desert had turned this place into a barren wasteland. Nothing was growing. But over the last 2 years, things have changed. The desert is no longer winning.
Nothing had been grown here for 40 years. When the UN World Food Programme told the villagers that they were going to bring this land back as part of the Great Green Wall, they said it was impossible. But here we are in Africa, in the desert at the northern edge of Senegal, and life has returned. Using techniques and systems that I'm going to tell you about in this video, the tides have changed.
Between Senegal and Mauritania is the Senegal River. This is the northernmost part where the Sahara Desert meets the Sahel.
When you look from space, you can actually see the lateral sand dunes of Mauritania where they hit the Senegal River. The Senegal River is really the divide between the Sahara and the Sahel in many parts of the river. So we have the Sahara Desert, then we have the Sahel, then we have the savanna, and then we have the rainforest. The design is to actually have a barrier of trees to stop the expansion of the desert southward.
We have put the half moons on contour lines, which means the rain, when it falls to the ground, it flows into this area here, which is a little bit lower so that it retains the water. And we create this embankment, okay, that's a little bit higher up and make sure that the water doesn't overflow, okay, and it stays here and it feeds these plants. So we are mainly using local species like the sorghum and the millet that actually has been domesticated here many thousands of years ago.
So this is the trick. You find the best plants to start this off, and it's all about the seeds. It's all about catching the water, holding it there, and building it up, building the biomass, building the fauna and everything else that needs to go with it, and then build it up with different plants every year until you have something amazing.
The half moon technology is actually an endogenous technology to the Sahel and has been forgotten over time. We have rescued it from the past. We have horticulture beds where we can plant tomatoes, okra, and so on. Here we have trenches where we have planted moringa, we have planted pigeon pea, and we have planted also some okra that has grown wildly here. And the idea here is that we have biomass trenches that will provide biomass as the system grows. In between these trenches, we have planting pits where we have planted fruit trees. We have guava, citrus. This is just the very first step in this pilot. We'll also be using other native species that we'll be planting in the pits that will drive the rejuvenation of the soil and the protection of the soil as the system starts growing into abundance and producing food and life for the people here. In its mature state, this system will look like a forest, okay, forest lines that will be producing biomass and fruit, and we'll have other lines in between where we'll be producing horticulture, vegetables. This is exactly the way nature works. We came across syntropic farming, which is a type of conservation agriculture that has been developed in Brazil based on global indigenous knowledge. In the whole world, many indigenous populations have a similar way traditionally to do agriculture that is different from conventional agriculture and which mimics forest dynamics. In the next step, we'll be growing trees here. So if we look at the vastness of this area here, we can plant 10,000s of trees into these structures.
Before, they were thinking about how to migrate. But they told me now, they don't think about that. With this borehole we put in place, now we are going to work 12 months on vegetable production. Now these young boys who are very key for the village security, for the village development, now don't need to go to live just the old people in the village. Now they will contribute to the local dynamic of the community. Now they are together, they have social cohesion.
So look at the effect this has had on immigration and migration in a very short period of time. So how do you bring peace and prosperity to the world? you fix the food system. You stop draining it dry. You stop spraying it with pesticides and rubbish. You make it right, and the whole world will recover. Hope you enjoyed that. Please like and subscribe. It makes the whole thing more viable.